balance sheet, asset side we will be discussing today, which is the right hand side of the balance sheet. So assets are those which all the debit balances which will be having. Normally you will come across only personal and real accounts, which are the form of assets. Okay, so all the debit balances in personal and real account are called as assets. Okay, now when we say assets, there are two types: non-current assets and current assets. So first we'll understand current assets, because so what is the current assets? Current assets are those assets which the company will be using in the operations of business. So what it can be? It will be stocks, which will be also called as inventory. Okay, closing stock, debtors, bills receivable, cash in hand, cash at bank, prepaid expenses, advance to suppliers. So these, if you see, it is during the operation of the business, whatever it is, they are the items. So this, the company will be owning. See, when they say assets, is owned by the business. So all the asset, all the things which is owned by the business is called an assets. Okay, so these are owned by the business. But why it is called current asset? Because it keeps on changing within the period of 12 months. In one accounting period, it will keep on moving. And it will be usually as the part of the operations. It is an outcome because of the operations of business. Like stock. So stock comprises of finished goods, work in progress and raw material. So this all, whatever at the end of the year end, on the last balance sheet date, whatever the status is what the company is owning it during the operations. And it will be changing in next 12 months period, because this raw material may get converted into WIP, this will convert into the FG, and this finished goods will be sold. Within 12 months it will be happening. So this is what the part of the inventory, and this inventory is nothing but a current asset. As this stock will be owning by the company, it is a current asset. As it is called as current asset because it keeps on moving within the period of 12 months. It is the part of the operations of the business. It's an outcome of the operations of the business. Okay. So these stocks are normally valued at cost or market price, which will be discussed in AS2. Okay. So these stocks will be valued as on the balance sheet date, and it will be appearing in the balance sheet on as on that day, whatever the figures it is. Okay. Debtors are the outcome of your sales. Credit sales are your debtors, which you will be recovering them in next 12 months. So these are also the current assets. Bills receivables are the nothing but one more form of the debtors. Okay, so they are also a current asset. Cash in hand, cash at bank, means cash in hand is whatever the money that in the company they are kept in the hard form cash. And cash at bank is your bank accounts. Prepaid expenses, like some expenses, like if it is a rent, more than 12 months you would have paid in this accounting period. So the extra whatever is you have paid, which is not related to that accounting period, is a prepaid expenses, which is nothing but an asset in this accounting period, because this is still not due, but you have paid in advance. So it is your asset. Advance to suppliers, like you have given to the creditors, you have given from the given to the suppliers some advance money for future purchases. That amount is also an asset. So whatever the company owns, still it is not due to it. It should not be due to the company. If it is due to the company and it is making payments, it becomes expenses. But if it is not due and it has made a payment, it's prepaid, it's advance. So it becomes an asset to the company. So these are the current assets. Okay. So current asset is those assets you should keep in mind, which will be forming the part of your operations It's an outcome of the operations of the business and it will keep on moving within the period of 12 months. Okay. Now we'll go to non-current asset. Non-current asset is totally opposite of the current asset. Here also one more thing, they have given the definition of current asset. So any asset shall be classified as current asset if it satisfies any of the following. Means anyone is also satisfied, it becomes current asset. So what they have given, it is expected to be realized or is intended for sale or consumption in the organization's normal operating cycle. So as I told you, it is held primarily for the purpose of being traded. Okay, means it should be the part of the operations of the business. That is the meaning they are saying. Okay, it is due to be realized within 12 months after the reporting date. It is a cash or cash equivalent unless it is restricted from being exchanged or used to settle a liability for at least 12 months after the reporting period. So this any one of it is satisfying, then it becomes a current asset. To be saying this traded, it you can say the investments you have made, the company business has made some investments with an intention just to sell and get money. Whenever they are doing production, they may require some cash. So for that they must be holding some investments and they may sell it whenever they fall short of money. These are called tradable investments and these investments are the part of your current assets. But there are non-tradable investments which are held just for the purpose of investment. Like the company would have invested in some joint ventures, in subsidiaries, they must have bought some company, they have purchase some businesses which they may not sell it just for money. They are holding it for some purpose. These are non-tradable investments which doesn't become part of current asset. It is a non-current asset. Okay. So this any one of it is satisfied, it becomes current asset. If nothing is satisfied, it becomes non-current asset. So what is non-current asset? Non-current assets comprises normally of fixed assets and investments. As I discussed right now, investments, those investments which are non-tradable, which are non-marketable, which are held for the purpose of investing in it, not for trading in it. These are those investments. Now fixed asset coming back to. So fixed assets are those assets which supplement or complement your operations. Like they are the part of your operations of business, but they doesn't become the part of your production process. Like assume a machinery. The business has bought some machinery which will be helping them to make the production of some items. This is important for them for doing that production. So this is a part of the production. Yes, but it does not change within the period of 12 months. When you buy a machinery, it is a long-term investment. At least it will be going for nearly 2-3 years. So these such type of things are non-current assets, which doesn't keep on moving, doesn't keep on changing. It is not intended for sale. You are not, the company is not owning it with the intent to sell it. It is for its own consumption purpose. It is for the supplementing the production process. So these are called fixed assets. Like motor car, the company buy the motor car for its director's use for business purpose. This is a non-current asset which is a fixed asset. Then land, the company may buy the land for future construction purpose, for making some factory or some other purpose. So these are the fixed assets. Okay, so fixed assets, the company's intended is to hold it for more than 1 year, for more than one accounting period. Next accounting means as on that balance sheet date, it will be holding for more than next 12 months. Okay, it should be complementing their business operations. Okay. So these are the criteria for non-current asset. So if it is not falling in current asset, it will be non-current asset. And in non-current asset, we understand there is a fixed assets and investments. Now, presentation. When we make balance sheet, we present the assets on the right hand side and we will list it from the least liquid to the most liquid. I am saying least liquid. What do you mean by least liquid? I am speaking about liquidity. Liquidity is those which we can convert into the cash immediately. Like cash itself is a highly liquid asset. Debtors, current assets are little lesser, it's highly liquid but lesser than your cash. Why? Because inventory, current inventory, investments, tradable investments, debtors, you may convert into the cash in next 12 months. So these are the highly liquid but lesser liquid than your cash. And fixed assets, investments are not held for trading purpose. They are held for the purpose of own consumption for more than next 12 months. So these are the least liquid. Okay. Like land. Land is the least liquid. When you invest in land, you may not sell it immediately in next 12 months, except to there may be a huge crunch or insolvency. Not we are discussing that. But land, when the business buys, its intent will be to use it for future or hold it for at least for next 5-6 years. So these fixed assets will be a least liquid items. So liquidity is also based on the current, like current assets will be highly liquid, non-current assets will be the least liquid. So when we are presenting, we start with the least liquid to the most liquid. So the first will be the least liquid and the last will be the most liquid item. So when you see the presentation, you will see the presentation of assets side starts with the fixed assets, and in fixed asset the first will be the land if the company is owning it, and the asset side ends with the least liquid, and you will see the least liquid will be the current assets, and in that cash at hand and cash at bank will be the last in the presentation. Okay, so we'll see the format of it. This is the format of balance sheet, and you will see it starts with fixed assets, in that land, building, plant and machinery, vehicles, computers, office equipments. These are all your fixed assets. And next comes the current assets, in that you will see stock, debtors, bills receivable, cash in hand, cash at bank, prepaid expenses and advances. This is the presentation of balance sheet on asset side. Same way for the liabilities. What the company owes, due, liability, we have to pay the company has the liability to pay this back. That will be listed on the left hand side, which is the liabilities, and it will be listed from own liability to the outsider liability. So the first will be the own liability and the last will be the outsider liabilities. Okay. So own liability means it starts from capital, reserves and surplus, long-term liabilities. Long-term liabilities are like loan from bank, financial institutions. And then comes the current liabilities, which will be creditors, bills payable, advances, outstanding expenses. Okay. And our accounts, financial statements end with the tallying of balance sheet. Balance sheet should tally. There should be no difference. No balancing figures and all comes in the balance sheet. The balance sheet, both sides should be totaling the same. Okay?